I need a drummer. I would have to go to Craigslist in Sydney, I think.
All right, as we were saying 20 years ago.
The set list is very long. It's going to go on for a while because it's been a long time. The last time we were in this general region, we were going to open for King Missile at the Irving Plaza. And there was a snowstorm of biblical proportions that we pulled into the East Village and stayed in a funeral home, a converted funeral home on 12th Street, down the street from Allen Ginsberg's apartment. And our van was frozen. This is not a joke. Our van was actually frozen to the earth, to the street, in a like 4-foot pile of ice. And we didn't get to play. We went to go see television at the Academy, and that was it. So that was 1993, and it would be, what, 1996 right now, right? All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you kindly.
It's Chris Peterson's 21st birthday tonight. Yeah, somebody buy him a drink, because, you know, in Australia, I found they don't drink at all. And since moving to Australia, Chris is, you know, he has not really taken to the national pastime. He looks down upon his fellow Australians as a bunch of lie-abouts, cross-Irish dim-witted people that he has no tolerance for, especially their boozing ways. Chris is very erudite.
That means smart.
I just made up that word right now. I don't really know the definition.
Revolver and steel.
another desire. Lost in a notebook whose torch they stay out to you. Coming to terms with the slow spike.
Stretch it out. It's kind of like a boxer, except in this band, it's more like the boxer is Robert De Niro at the kind of later stage of his career, in that rather famous boxing movie that we all know so well. Jake has had too much steak and brandy the night before. The set list, Chris looked at it and he said, there's a lot of rock at the top there, but you know, I mean, you might as well, right?
Stand by,
all right. David is having whammy bar problems. Come on, that was the best one all fucking evening and nobody laughed. Come on. Somebody over there is like, I didn't hear that cackle.
I chuckled.
All right.
what you mean. I had a dream, I knew how to fly out of a prison made out of time. Now I stay awake night after night. I stay awake night after night.
Thank you.
Some of you may or may not know, we did a record that took 15 years. We were trying for the world record. We were in competition with the Grateful Dead. the Nina Simone Archives and the Counting Crows, as I recall, for longest time to complete an album from start to finish. And Guns N' Roses took it. And you know, I mean, Axl and I were like this, and you know, it's hard to be angry with a friend, but you know, I felt dissed. Just so, you know, it's a personal grudge, I'll get over it. But so anyhow, we did a record, it's called What's Left for Kicks. It's all covers. And in fact, remarkably, I actually have copies available for sale after the show. I know that's surprising to you all, but they are here. And in fact, because all four original monks of Doom are in the room at the same time, we will in fact sign it for you if you buy it. And to top it all off, we will take a photograph with you and Chris Peterson will take his shirt off when we do that photograph. This is a solemn Boy Scout style promise.
Believe me.
When it all devolves into a fist fight later, you'll know who to blame.
Yeah.
Well, it seems all right so far, I would say. So, I know there are some of you here who actually have traveled quite a way, and that's always a pleasure and a privilege. So, I know there was probably some sacrifice involved in that somehow, some way. So, on a sincere note, thanks. And reverting back to my usual kind of snarky self, because you know that's more fun. I think this is a Franz Ferdinand song. We're at about the 1/3 mark, okay? So just like prepare. If you need a drink or a bathroom break, you know, it's over there. Bar, bathroom. Response will be based on facts, providing All right. All right. At one point we lived in the Bay Area, you know, the left coast thing. And Philip Lifman Rocks, A.K.A. Snakefinger, was a bit of an influence, just a little influence on some young acid-laden teenagers living in the Bay Area. Tragically, he died of a heart attack in Austria after eating a steak and playing a game of tennis. That is actually, in fact, true. A friend of mine was on tour with him. Bringing a body back from Austria is... apparently, it's quite an ordeal. I haven't actually had to do that. I've just had to bring lead singers back from Sweden, but I can imagine it's comparable, so... This is all being recorded for posterity, right? And somebody's gonna send it directly to Richmond, Virginia to get my ass busted, right?
It's over. Ready? Make it sound number one.
Snakefinger. It's interesting because in 1991, I was, you know, listening to the birds and reading the news and writing about like Basra and Jerusalem and apocalypse and bombs dropping and all this shit. Yeah, it's like The Watchmen. It's like I'm in a fucking comic book, you know. So I am in a comic book. It's true, but you know. I am actually a believer in peace and justice and prosperity and, you know, individual rights and all those good things. And so let's go someplace else. All right, yep, Australian rules drumming over there. We did change the set list, I will admit that. Chris is feeling a little slighted, so everybody show Chris a little love, just a wee touch.
Chris Peterson from Sydney, Australia on drums. you know him and you love it.
What's really frightening is it's actually really fucking a good drummer.
Yeah.
on the electric mandolin over there is David Immerglück. I'm playing the gold top Les Paul over here, Greg Leischer. From Sydney, Australia, on the drums is Chris Peterson. I'll come up with a good pseudonym for myself in a matter of moments, but time? Oh, take my time. I'll work on it. Maybe. Everything's going off mark now. You've just broken the general kind of setlist barrier over there, so watch out.
It's when our father taught us.
Again, do it again.
My name's Jeremy Spencer, and it's been a pleasure playing for you.
If you're good, I mean, I don't want to make you do something you don't want to do.
Across my heart to protect me from your brilliant disguises.
Here, everybody get in. Here. All right, come on.
Fucking tourists.
Now, when you guys see Camper, you know, you don't see behavior like this. We wonder what happened, you know?
I do have a disclaimer. I haven't dyed my hair in years. In fact, this isn't my real hair.
There's a band called the Blue Orchids, which was a fall offshoot from the early 80s. And they did a record called Money Mountain. Is this on Money Mountain or is this on the Blue Orchid EP? Do you know?
No, it's on the, what was the other one?
The Blue Orchid EP? Is it like a four-song EP or something?
The
Money Mountain.
Yeah,
Money Mountain. There's a song on a record called Money Mountain, which was released on Rough Trade in 1982. Martin Drama was the songwriter.
We actually used to listen to this shit when we were driving on tour in a band together through the bleak Midwest, making our way to New Haven, Connecticut.
Thank you.
It's a hefty mouthful, that's right.
Pell-mell from the San Francisco Bay Area. One of the finest instrumental bands, next to the Monks of Doom, of course, that you've never heard. We'll be right back. Last two, a rock opera and a Red Crayola song.
You could give me a taste more of my vocal right there. It would be a big help to me. It's a God and
I wrote this song based on an Edward Gorey book long ago, and in order to record it, we had to secure the rights from Edward Gorey. And so my manager at the time got me Edward Gorey's phone number. And they said, you know, he's a very approachable, eccentric gentleman living in Buzzards Bay up in Massachusetts. And so I called Edward Buzzards Bay. Yes, I gave Edward Gorey a call, and I said, yeah, I'm in this band called Monks of Doom. Say that again, Monks of Doom. That's a nice name. I like that name. It's like we've done an interpretation of one of your books called The Insect God. Oh, well, you know that's been done before, which I did not. It was a little soul-crushing. I was like, who did that? Well, Michael Mantler with Robert Wyatt on drums, I believe. Soul-crushing moment. But nonetheless, he said, I like to encourage the youth. And so he, you know, and I got blessings, you know. It was like going to the Pope for me, so...
Crusade, with apprehension, the heavy
Goodbye, Millicent.
Take me wherever I wanna go.
It's David Immergluck on the lead guitar, Chris Peterson on the drums, Greg Leischer. I am Victor Krumenacher. Thank you for coming out. Thank you, Scott Long, for having us. It's a rare, rare treat, and we appreciate you putting it on the line for us. So thank you very much.
Ripley's Believe It or Not, The Monks of Doom.